know that this is a lot. Our track champion in super late models for 2002, he cannot be with us next week for the trophy presentations, Rick Rogers out of Knoxville, Tennessee. Let's give Rick a big hand now. He drove all season to get to this. He will be at his son's wedding next week. Oh yeah, okay, Buddy's the grandpa, and then Rick, and it's his son that's getting married, Rick's son. So Art or John, whoever has the mic down in the pits. Okay, John's heading that way, and we will have the trophy presentation.
Here the guy is, your track champion, super late models, Rick Rogers out of Knoxville, Tennessee. Rick, he's came up here, raced all year with us. I'm gonna set this thing up on the car. Get his crew in here. It's this envelope right here, Rick, little reward for winning this. These people don't know, $4,000 in here. That'll help a little bit running one of these cars. This guy has supported us. I mean, came here and raced with us all year. Earlier in the year, I heard over Bull's Gap, he had blistered them running real good, and I thought, man, we need him at Tazewell, and not Bull's Gap. And we got lucky, he rolled through the gate. He stayed with us all year. Rick's a great guy. I mean, his program has been up over the years, and the last couple years, he's been working on it, been down a little bit. But definitely this year, Rick, you set the standards, your program's together, your son. I mean, I don't know if he'll be right after next week or not, but this year he's done real well. I want to congratulate you guys. I appreciate you, part of Tazewell Speedway. We really appreciate you, and congratulations. A great job done, and I know it's tough. How about a hand for Ricky Rogers? I'm going to let you say a word to these people, Rick. I know you got a bunch of people to thank. And, I mean, all these boys, all this crew, your dad was an awesome driver. Everybody knows him up here. And I came in here, his names is all out here, you know. And I never did get to see the guys race, but evidently it was pretty good. But I've seen you guys race, and I've raced against you and everything. And I know you're an awesome talent. You're a good person to race with, and I appreciate you. And I know you fellow drivers do, too. Thank you, Rick. Congratulations.
Thank you, John. I appreciate it. First of all, man, we worked really hard for this. And I need to thank the Lord. And my pastor is here, Bruce Morrison, and I want him to lead us in prayer.
Let us pray. Our gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for the freedom that we have in this country, freedom we have together, to do things that we enjoy and to create and compete. And we just ask your blessings upon each one tonight, that you would help us to have a good time and a safe time. And thank you for all that you do for us, for it's in your name we pray and in your name we live. Amen.
Thank you, Bruce. I appreciate it. I'll tell you what, I'm gonna be on this mic for a few minutes. I hope everybody bear with me. I've got so many people to thank for what we've done. This year has been an awesome year for us. First off, I have to thank my mom and dad. They've been awesome. They've been supportive all through my racing. I'd like to thank them. I'd also like to thank my son for all the countless hours that he spends working on his race car, keeping it prepared to make us go round and round every week. Nobody knows how much time is involved doing what we do. In order to keep these things together, you have to really work a lot of hours. And he spends more time than anybody. And I love him just for all of it. Thank you. let's see. John was right. Last year, the last couple of years, we've really struggled. We changed some things. At the end of last year, I went to my engine builder, Vic Hill, and I told him, I said, look, Vic, I said, I really don't know what I'm doing here. I said, I need somebody to help me. And Vic was nice enough to hook me up with some setup stuff that wasn't, I didn't know what I was doing. It was just, he knew what it done, and he really, not only has he helped me with the power plant, which is an awesome power plant, he's helped me with the chassis so much that I'm going to let him say a word or two. Thanks, Vic.
You're welcome, Ricky. You've done us a good job up here. I think last year we had Jason Trammell won the limited championship, and we never have anybody run that dominant as you've done up here in the open class. And like I said, I'm just happy for you. I know how hard it is to do the things that it takes to win a championship. And just congratulations.
Thanks. I appreciate it. Let's see here. Well, also I have to thank Goddard Performance Parts. Sanford has also helped me a lot with some setup stuff just some tweaking on the cars that I needed to do. That's helped it also. And all those people at Goddard's have been excellent to me. People at RaceCan, they've helped me a tremendous amount. That's, that's pretty much all there. I've also got to thank some more people here that help me each week. First off, I need to thank my wife. My wife is very supportive. She's there 24/7 if it meant going to the lake or going racing, she'd let me go racing, I guess. Thanks, honey. Let's see here. I also have to thank Darrell and Carrie Elliott. They come down from Kingsport. They live in Kingsport. They drive 2 hours every week to come and help me race. Darrell comes down from up there. He's a certified welder. He works for Johnson and Hiller. He's been awesome. Thank you, Darrell. I appreciate it. Thank you, Carrie. Where's Carrie? Thanks, Carrie. Let's see. Next off, I need to thank Gene Grant. Gene Grant has raced with me for, I quit racing for a while and I started back about 10 years ago. And Gene's helped me with my tires for 10 years now. And he's chose the right tires more times than he's chose the wrong tires. Gene, I appreciate it. Thank you. Let's see, Zane Duncan, he's helped us all year. Y'all might not know the name, but his father's our senator, Jimmy Duncan. And thank you, Zane, we appreciate you. Next of all, I've got a lot of people that come to the races week in and week out to support me. My father-in-law and his girlfriend, Dan Pine, and Sylvia, what's your last name, I'm sorry? Beardsley, they come every week and support me every week. My mother-in-law, I don't know if she's here, she's up in the stand somewhere. Karen Chambers and Jim Chambers, thank you all. Let's see, who else do I need to thank here? Oh, here, my niece and nephew, Christopher and Shelby Pine, they come, help me here every week, support me. We got some new people that come, that's been coming to help me, or just to holler for us. This is Natalie Oakley and her mom and dad, Darrell and Lynn. And anyway, I just need to thank everybody. Thank all of y'all. If it wasn't for you people up there in the stands, I couldn't be right here right now. Thank you all so much. And I love every one of you. Even the people that don't like me, I love you all too. Thank you.
How about a big hand for Ricky Rogers? Thank you, Rick. I mean, it's always good to see somebody put God first in their life. I mean, man, that's great. That's great for these kids and these people. That touches me more than anything out here, Rick. You guys are great sports. I mean, you're great sportsmen. Your daddy, I mean, all he's bringing you up. You've done a great job. Your crew, your family, we appreciate you. Hope everything was good for you. I know it was good for us. I'm glad to see you have a good year. You're deserving. And I know you're on a roll. And They'll just have to deal with that from now on, I guess. I said, this race car's always been pretty, but this year is fast, too. Give him a hand, Ricky Rogers.